So we're here today at the Minnesota Brow Lash Academy. I have master artist Kay.
Hi everyone.
Say hi. And we have our students this week. Say hi everyone.
Hi.
They're very busy.
Hi.
They're very, there they are. There they are.
All
right. They're doing great. And we're going to be watching a microblading service today, starting out with some pigment choice for our model on the table. The design has already been drawn, and so now we're going to choose the appropriate color that we're going to design the brow with.
So this is rich brown, which is pretty rich and really nice color. So I'm going to smear it out, which match pretty well with her color as well, as you see, right?
If you want to sit up, then you can.
So this is rich brown. So this is the color I want to choose for her. Let me grab you a mirror so that we can show you as well.
It does look nice.
Oh,
here, I'm sorry.
Thank you.
Thank you. So this is the main color I want to choose for you, rich brown. So let's just put it down like that, okay? Mm-hmm. All right, so I want to mix with a little bit of a lighter color that has the goldish shade, which is a beautiful blonde, which you have in your kit. What is the base color of beautiful blonde?
Yellow.
What else?
Green.
And what else?
A little bit of orange.
A little bit of the red.
Red.
A little bit.
Probably a lot.
Okay. And then hazelnut, which is my favorite color to mix. Very similar to
Beautiful Blonde. What does hazelnut have?
See, but it has a goldish. It has the green base, which is because of hers. See that?
Oh, her eye color.
It matched better than the beautiful blonde. Mm-hmm. So if you mix a little bit of this, it will give a very nice, rich color. Mm-hmm. So, and then this is autumn gold, which just has some red in it. I know I'm not using autumn gold, but I'm just gonna wanna show you guys. See, pretty clear that has red in it, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's great color for some people having red, like a redhead. Okay, so that's how you mix some of the color.
Probably, is that yours? It's probably close to yours a little bit.
So I am going to use this combination with you, for you.
Okay.
So we don't want to add any red. You do actually have some red in the skin tone, so we want to stay away from red a little bit.
Okay, next sense? Perfect. So now that we've chosen our pigment color, we are going to clean that off and proceed with our microblading procedure.
Q-tip. What's that one?
Have you watched that yet?
Yeah.
Do I just ignore that?
Let's wait for his next message.
Okay. Okay.
There's some alcohol in too. That doesn't take that off.
Green soap works really good to get pigment off.
Oh, it's too small.
Oh, it really, yeah, at the end. Green soap is just wonderful.
I wonder if that's the same thing my mom has. Because I use green soap for my daughter. Her sensitive skin.
It could be.
Mm-hmm. Oh, really?
Yeah.
Pick your colors. Or I'm letting it go.
Okay.
You can help me.
All right. So.
You going to mix any? We can if none of them is light enough or.
So far, I like the one second to the lightest.
I am going to use rich brown and my beautiful blonde. I'm going reflect the pigment out really well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Can I see that? Is it dry yet? Yeah. Let
this one right here.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh, you can put it in the shaker.
That's too orangey.
So.
Too blonde.
The blonde?
That was a blonde. Mm-hmm.
Is that
the
right
in there?
The second one matches your eye color.
Right.
The second one does?
Yeah, that one.
Hazelnut.
So what's your percentage mixture?
This one will be about 20%. We don't want to be
too light.
Because our real result would drop about 50%. So we don't want to be too light.
And what drops 50%?
Yeah, it would drop about 40 to 50%. As you see, the color it drops already. See.
Because some be like, I want it dark.
Yeah.
You know. And then
it's still
like, oh,
rich brown, but has a shade of greenish, yellowish,
mm-hmm.
goldish in
yeah.
here.
How long have you had your braces on?
October.
And you have more. Very
2 years.
Really?
Mm-hmm. So another year and a half ish.
And why did you go with braces instead of?
Because
it might mix a little bit.
I don't like that you can take a because
she wants it more natural, so I just want to make sure that it is
right. Or and then I feel like
light enough
too,
for
like,
her.
A lot of your saliva is going to get stuck in there, and I don't know, it just feels so like enclosed.
Yeah,
you know?
I did it for a year.
Did you like it?
We didn't take a picture of you.
My girlfriend did it, and she
I
didn't. Never consistent with it.
Mm-hmm.
I was
before.
Before we did, but not the approved.
You
do you?
Do
for the one with the
she's
dots?
I'm
sure we take the picture for after it's finished.
Oh, of course.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, I have them. They're like retainer I sleep with that night.
Okay, yep.
Because
okay.
they put the permanent ones in. And
they
do. They did. And they literally, they were in 1 week. I was on the plane playing on Mexico. I just broke out of my home. And then like 2 weeks later, the top one broke off.
Oh,
and he's
yeah.
like, I guess you're just not the kind of person that can wear those. And my niece said she's had hers up for like 15 years.
Yeah, yeah.
Mine broke 2 days after I had my
yeah.
retainer.
So I'm like, okay, forget that. Just
the retainer.
Ones that I wear at night.
Yeah.
But,
how does that work?
It's fine. I mean, I'm pretty good about it. There
good.
Have been like, you know, quite a lot of times on the
okay, so I will start plating.
I heard a lot of people like use it,
like
forget about it.
And that's why they said that
was
put
it in the
app. And we are using the disposable blade here,
yeah,
Angela, brand new, or just open.
Yeah,
I had tape, I started out taking them off, and then all of a sudden I'd go back in and go, something's wrong, these are chipping. And then it dawned on me, it was because I was alongside these little tiny.
So for walking, I always like to have a.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Some sponge in
yeah.
my hand in case I need to
fine.
Wipe or anything
I,
right
my
away.
Teeth
so,
had, like, I had this tooth that was kind of nice. I didn't have
which I
much
am
much
used to wipe around her. Here.
Good.
Okay.
I like
okay.
Oh, yeah, that is.
I would start on her right brow first.
When that retainer was on, just for that 1 week trying to block for that.
Okay.
Remember, we just dip the pigment on the one side, on the
yeah.
other side.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
For stretching.
I don't know, I don't think I'm
you can use these three fingers.
Here, but for sure down here. Yep, and then I have our retainers.
So,
yeah. So we're gonna use these three fingers to stretch.
It's funny how quick your mouth wants to
pull it up, and then
seriously.
You can use your pinky
yeah.
to pull it down. It's
yeah.
extremely important to stretch.
Like,
really
oh,
good.
Feel like it's just
okay? So.
Weird.
I know.
Like, those water stacking things?
Well, when they put those, when they start first do it, they put these little cement pieces on your teeth, and that's what manipulate and turn them. They're
mm-hmm.
pressure points.
Mm-hmm.
And so those, I
you hear that?
On, I just
mm-hmm.
had those, and I just hated it. I just
mm-hmm.
felt like there was something on my teeth.
Yeah.
It just bugged me. So when they took them all off when I was done,
yeah.
I was just like,
relief, right?
Oh my God, I didn't know.
Yeah.
It went very shallow.
Right.
Okay. So leave a space, and then I'm gonna go to the next one.
How is she doing with those?
Now Craig says, okay, we'll go get it.
She's doing good. She's just laying on her
Of course. But didn't whatchamacallit just go? Didn't Jeff just go? No, Jeff was asking him to do something
so
else.
So we agreed on the olive oil.
Okay. So now I have the first six already, right? So I am going to do the transition.
Yeah,
sure.
Right.
What?
So ladies,
yes.
Can we focus on here until we finish this real quick? So I am going to do the, I had the first six hand strokes already, so I am going to work on the transitions point right here. Okay. And then we are going to work on the bottom. See that? Now I am going to fill the top outline. Did you hear the noise?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's funny. I was just thinking.
You feel it at all?
Yeah, a little bit. It's not too bad. Yet.
I myself, I like to box my thing in like that. Okay. Now we have the outline.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
See?
Yep.
So we are going to rub the pigment in. When you rub the pigment in, make sure that because these strokes are cut
this
vertically,
way,
so you open it horizontally, so that you open the cut, so that you can rub the pigment in. You push it in. Okay. This side, you could just open it up vertically because the hair strokes are horizontal. So we're just gonna rub it in. Do you wanna go ahead and cut without numbing, or do you want to put in some numbing?
I think I'm gonna try to push through. No numbing.
You sure?
Yeah.
Okay. What a tough cookie.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right, I'm gonna move to this side. Can you move toward me, your whole body?
Oh, yeah.
Like all the way. Because sometimes if your hand is reaching, it's hard for you, you can put a pillow on her chest, and then you can do that.
Am I good, Kay?
Oh, you are good.
Okay.
Perfect. Okay. Again, stretching. Stretching, very important to stretch properly. Okay. On this side, especially this side, is very, it's harder to,
mm-hmm.
to do
to
that,
stretch with,
to
yeah,
stretch
finger,
that
yeah.
way. So you can just put your finger right here.
Okay.
So.
Would you like more light?
Mm, not good.
Oh, to have young eyes again.
Hello. One. Two. Three. And we leave a space, and then four. Just do the transition. Seven. See? So I'm going to fill the bottom first. Stroke.
Right, we're ready. Apparently he's ready too.
Okay. We have a turn. And you can even stretch with mm-hmm. these two fingers right like this as well. Okay.
Mm-hmm. So do you actually use the dots? To start, I mean, you start your cut on the dot, or is it just a coincidence?
I do cut right on the dot.
Okay.
So I use a dot as my guide. Mm-hmm. And some people use the inside of the line, mm-hmm. or some people use the outside of the line, and some people just use a concealer. There's okay. many ways mm-hmm. of how to do it, and some people just use a pencil alone. Sure. There's many different yeah. ways, so yep. it's just what you like to use.
Okay.
So. I'm gonna wipe this. I'm gonna give you some numbing solution because the numbing really helped to stop the. The bleeding a little bit.
Okay.
See, these hair strokes are really light.
Should I keep filming, Kay?
And a little bit.